The rule of 100 states that if you spend 100 hours in a year, which is 18 minutes a day in any discipline, touch typing, coding, climbing, whatever, you'll be better than 95% of the world in that discipline. You can go and practice your Git skills for 18 minutes a day, but there's a shortcut that doesn't only get you there faster, it also does most of the work for you. So, how do you stay ahead of 95% of everyone else? Ever found yourself fighting an interactive rebase session? Felt like banging your head into a wall when fixing conflicts? Or how about this feeling of brain cells literally losing connection when you try to stage a line and find out 5 more functions are staged with it? Git is powerful, but what good is that power when everything is so damn hard to do? This is a quote that comes from a tool that I love, but wasn't paying enough attention until recently. Most of my basic GitOps are running through Fugitive. Link to the video is up here if you're interested. If you're a mere mortal like me, and you're tired of hearing how powerful Git is, when in your daily life it's a powerful pain in your ass, LazyGit might be for you. So let's talk about Fugitive, and at the end of the video I'll show you how to combine both into a system that will get you superpowers. In case you're unfamiliar with it, Fugitive is Tpop's Vim Git integration that brings almost all Git operations to your IDE with bindings. You open the status, stage or unstage entire files, view the summary of commits that you're staged or unpushed, etc. No need for external software or CLI. You can also stage individual hunks from within your editor. However, this is where it falls short. The hunks are decided for you. It'll grab a group of changes, whereas if you want specific lines, that's something that Git or Fugitive doesn't do for you, at least not easily, and we'll come back to that. Once my changes are staged, committing them and pushing them are all easy actions done from within Vim, so that after a short while doing them, plus viewing the status and making changes becomes second nature, or muscle memory, if you will, something I don't have to spend any energy thinking about. But what happens if you need to do something a little bit more complicated, or would just like to use an actual UI? This is where LazyGit comes in. Installation is as easy as any other binary. Use brew or snap or just grab the binary from the repo. When I fire it up, I'm greeted with a UI with multiple sections, easy to understand and navigate. Navigation is as smooth as using your arrows, or better yet, Vim motions. Up and downs move internally in the focused list, and with left and right, the focus shifts to the next or previous menu. You can also use tab and shift tab exactly for that. One additional important motion is zooming in and out. That's also an incremental action, and it's a cyclic operation, so you can zoom in all the way and keep going further. That will just cycle back to the original layout and save you from unwanted motions, quitting the thing and coming back. This is done with plus and minus. Remember earlier how I staged a hunk using Fugitive and got the entire section staged? Well, sometimes you may want to add a single line. With LazyGit, just hit space on the line you want and watch it jump to the staging area on the right. It works backwards just as easily. Hit space again on the staged changes window to pop it back to the unstaged area. There's also an indication in the file section to the left showing either an unstaged, partially changed, or fully staged file next to its name. This is specifically helpful when reviewing changes and looking for unstaged bits of code that may be relevant to the current commit. Interactive rebasing is one of the most unpleasant experiences Git can offer, and this is another area where LazyGit shines. Hit E to start a rebase on a certain commit, then use S to squash, F for fix up, D to drop, and E to edit. M will bring up the rebase options menu to continue or abort the operation. And by the way, another cool feature for those of you who like squashing commits regularly, it works just as a one-off. So by standing on a commit and pressing S, it'll be squashed without an interactive session. To explore a certain commit, just hit enter and get a menu of changed files which are easily navigatable with a preview window presenting changes made. At any point, hit the question mark operator to open the key bindings menu, which you can filter using the slash operator. Just like in Vim, so for example, if I'd like to reset my changes, instead of remembering syntax or making mistakes, G opens the reset menu, which I can then reset soft or hard or mixed. Every menu is self-explanatory with bindings showing alongside every operation. This resembles Zellige a lot if you use it, and I love the design that always has the user experience in the center, something that's hard to say about Git generally. If you want to cherry pick a commit, hit C and then V to paste it on the wanted target. How genius is that? Just copy pasting commits. Every operation also has its own self-explanatory confirmation window so you can understand what's going on, approve operations, or cancel them. The same goes for bisect. If you're unfamiliar with Git bisect, this is one of the nicest ways to figure out which commit introduced a bug, by marking commits either as good or as bad. The manual process that Git offers in the CLI becomes visual here. If I'm honest, Git bisect was never a pain for me anyway, but if I'm already using an interface for all things Git, it better have the option. So here I can, again, check in the process whether a commit is good or gone bad, and throughout the process, once Git identifies the commit that's gone wrong, it reports that and then we can fix the bug. Similar to the CLI, it says the bisect is complete and points out where it was introduced. When the changes are finally ready, it's time to commit and push them. And as you guessed it, standing on the files in the browser, hitting C to get the commit menu and the title and description that most users don't even bother to write. Hitting enter on the title finalizes the commit, and that's now ready to be pushed with P. Once again, the amazing UX is self-explanatory, telling us that tab will toggle the focus, and this is exactly what I expect from a UX that helps me simplify processes, exactly like Zellige does. Now I want to take you to something LazyGit can do well, but I prefer another method. Worktrees is my favorite way of managing any Git repo. This saves me the hassle of stashing changes when needing to move to another branch while coding, and makes my life easier when I want to review diffs in neovim. My go-to is the Primogems plugin for Git Worktree Envim, which also integrates with Telescope and is just such a sweet experience, I won't replace it. Beyond that, it's better to run worktrees within a bare Git repo. Don't worry about it if you don't use worktrees at all. That Lazy currently does not support, so it can create worktrees and manage them for you, but I'd stick with Telescope and bare repos for this one. Once the worktree is created within LazyGit, it's added to the list, which can then be easily toggled and switched. I still prefer the way Telescope does this by showing me a preview of the current file across multiple trees, including the option to open as many trees as I want within separated panes. This is not a problem of LazyGit, but rather a plus of using something similar within the IDE. Another great plus of LazyGit is the presentation of the commit tree. This one isn't very impressive, as this is a private side project of mine, so here's a better example from the source itself. It shows beautifully the structure of branches, points of intersection, authors, and commits. Ain't that a sight for sore eyes? Before we're going to take LazyGit one step further in productivity with a small tweak, here's the last simple yet brilliant feature it offers: comparison of commits. Here's the trick. Just hit Shift W when you're on a commit, and voila, a handy menu pops up. This little gem lets you pick a commit as your reference point, then choose another commit, and guess what? You can instantly see how they differ in the main view. Press enter and you'll dive into the files and see exactly what's changed. And if you feel like mixing things up, go ahead and press Shift W again. This will bring back the diff menu where you can flip the diff direction or say goodbye to diff mode. Oh, and if you're done comparing and you want to go back to your visual workflow, just tap escape as always. And now for my setup. In my mind, every system I pick, everything that gets in or gets out of my workflow is judged by one main parameter: friction. Is this adding friction to my process, or is it taking some away, making my mental flow consistent and for longer periods of time? If I want to use LazyGit, having to step out of my editor, open another split or a floating terminal is a bit of a pain which cuts my train of thought. However, with Tmux, this is a breeze. I just fire up a pop-up with LazyGit inside that I can then use and kill when I'm done, right from within the editor. The nice thing about it is that I don't actually have to be in Vim, but it works anywhere really, as long as I have an active Tmux session, which I always do. For the Zellige folks out there, you can do exactly the same with floating panes. Your case actually is even nicer, since these can be moved around and customized. More on Zellige in the video above. LazyGit is fantastic for everyday Git actions, but I found that personally, I need to stay in the same environment for most of my tasks, otherwise my ADHD just kicks in. To solve that, I just pop Fugitive for everything. The video is right up here. And if you still feel like Vim motions aren't ingrained enough into your muscle memory, here's a great method to quickly learn and remember them easily. Thank you for watching.